Can we come together on one big thought before we go any further? And that is that this idea that is being popularized in modern society and culture, and it's been around for longer than modern culture and society, and that is that your feelings are truth. This is one of the scariest ideas floating around right now in our culture. And this is what we are being told. We are being told that if you have feelings, dare I say you have repetitive feelings, you have feelings that keep coming back, for you to resist those, or for you to fight those, or for you to stand against those or question those, you are fundamentally disingenuous and you are not authentic. When you have repetitive feelings, those feelings are not just feelings, that is who you really are. Those urges, those desires, those impulses, that defines who you are. So lean into that, follow those impulses, follow those desires. In other words, live your truth, or more specifically, live how you feel. Okay. At face value, it kind of sounds fun. I'll admit that. It does. It kind of sounds fun until you step back as a logical person and go, the whole constructs of our society and governments, countries and continents are predicated upon what? People not doing what they want to do right when they want to do it, whenever they want to do it, with whoever they want to do it with. In fact, we have police forces, and do you know one of the reasons they're here? To keep you from doing that exact thing you want to do when you want to do it. Why? Because it will be chaos. So they make for great hashtags, but they make for a horrible existence. So it's this idea is fundamentally flawed, that we all go from this place and, hey, I felt it again. Oh, there it is again. Yep, that's, I'm gonna do it. That's me. No. Don't follow your heart. Listen to me. Question your heart. Jeremiah says, the heart is wicked and deceitful. Who can know it? The answer is not you, not me, only one, the one who made it, God. Question your feelings, question your desires, question your heart. One of the most diabolical ideas or advice you could ever get is, hey, slugger, champ, follow your heart. Like, who can even define the heart? Do you know how many centuries theologians have debated what the mind, the will, the heart, the soul? The guy in front of me in the plane that I fly into Portland, he's reading a whole thesis on the soul, and the guy read, we're confused. The heart is just, it's kind of like, it's, I don't know, follow your heart? I can't even find my heart. What kind of fractured advice is that? I believe living by feelings is a fundamentally dehumanizing existence. It reduces you, it animalizes you. You become animalistic and you end up living by your instincts. And I am here to say that I have never met a single person, and I've been out and about a bit. I've never met the person who says, hey, can I tell you my story? I have learned to do whenever I feel it, however I feel it, I do it right, I act immediately on what I feel, my sensations, my desires, and my urges. And can I just say, for the last 25 years, the trajectory of my life has gone steadily just like this. I am so happy and fulfilled. Never. Instead, you meet people who've taken this simple yet absolutely toxic idea, and what do they end up with? Man, I don't know. I'm lost. I've done it. What do I do now? Living by your instincts is not what God designed you for. Okay? It's not what you want. The truth is, some of you want some stuff right now. It's not what you want. God actually knows what you want. I don't really know what I want, but I know that God knows what I want. And so when I want what I want, I question why I want it. And then I wonder, God, is this what you want me to want? Because I'm wanting something right now and I really want it. But if you don't want it, I don't want it. I mean, I do want it, but I don't want it if you don't want it. Because you know what I should want. And if I want what you want, I'm gonna end up where I ultimately really want. I don't wanna be alone in a big house by myself. My kids despise me. My wife has left me. And my grandkids don't even know me. With a strong drink in my hand going, I lived it up. Have you ever met that person who's like, that's what I'm looking for? no. But yet we're not telling the truth in our society. That more often than not, that is the end of living by your feelings.